You see again, each light is giving molecule. Absorbs a single quantum of radiation. That is, absorbs a single photon for becoming excited. That is, gain its energy of activity and undergoing the reaction. Thus, one photon can excite one molecule. That is, A plus H nu, A star. H nu means one, it's one photon. Now, if we need one mole photon, where one mole photon is counted one Einstein, okay, one Einstein. Thus, one mole of photon excites a mole of reactor, one mole reactor. Since one photon can excite one molecule, so one mole photon can excite one Einstein. One mole photon means one Einstein can excite one mole reactor, okay. So, one mole of photon is counted one Einstein. Now, the energy corresponding to one Einstein is, you see, E equals to Na into H nu, where Na is the Avogadro number and H is the Planck's constant, nu is the frequency of radiation. Now, nu equals to C by lambda, where lambda is the wavelength of light. Now, Na equals to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23, H is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 27 arc second in this system. Now, the velocity of light is 2.9979 into 10 to the power 10 centimeters per second. And the lambda is in angstrom unit, that is lambda into 10 to the power minus 8 centimeters. Okay. So, the energy in arg. Now, this is actually 1.1961 into 10 to the power 16 divided by lambda arg. Now, you can convert it to joule, and the value is 1.1961 into 10 to the power 9 divided by lambda. So, this is the energy of Einstein. Now, we have said that one photon can excite one molecule, but one molecule may not react. A plus H nu A star, this is the primary step of photochemical reaction. There can be other processes. Okay, I said already that one photon can excite one molecule may not react. There can be other processes also. Because A star may give back A, or in some cases may cause the reaction of many other molecules. These are termed as secondary processes. If you consider the reaction between hydrogen and bromine, and if you consider the photochemical reaction, or the photochemical combination of hydrogen bromine reaction, where the initiation reaction is BF2 absorbs photon converted to 2BF. That is, two reactive intermediate species are formed. So, this is the primary state of activation. This is the primary photochemical reaction. Now, this reactive intermediate species, bromine. Next, react with the another reaction molecule, hydrogen, and form the product. That is, Br plus H2 is Br plus H. Now, again, this H combines with bromine molecule. H plus Br2 is Br plus Br. So, this is the inhibition state. Okay. Sorry, this is not the inhibition state. This is the propagation state. There are two propagation states. Now, the inhibition state is H plus H plus H plus HBr. Okay, H plus HBr, H2 plus Br. Okay, and the termination state is Br plus Br equals to Br. So, in case of photochemical combination between hydrogen and bromine, the primary photochemical reaction is Br2 H2 Br. Now, the rest of the reactions, these are actually thermal reactions. Okay. So, these are termed as secondary processes. Therefore, although one quantum may excite one molecule may not react. One quantum excite one molecule may not react. Consequently, we define quantum yield. That is phi. Thus, for a reaction involving secondary processes, the Stark-Einstein law should be restated as each radiation absorbing molecule in a primary photochemical process. This photochemical process is replaced by primary photochemical process, absorbs only one quantum of radiation which poses the activity. Okay. So this is the restatement of Stark-Einstein law. Now this is the definition of quantum yield. Quantum yield is defined as number of molecules reacting divided by number of quanta absorbed. The ratio of number of molecules reacting and number of quanta absorbed. Now you can convert it to, if you multiply both numerator and denominator with the Avogadro number, then phi is done. Now phi is changed as number of moles reacting divided by number of Einstein absorbed. Now you can convert it to rate. That is, if the radiation is absorbed for a specific period, then you have number of moles reacting per unit time divided by number of Einstein absorbed per unit time. Number of Einstein absorbed per unit time means intensity. Since intensity is defined as the energy per unit time per unit area, if you consider the area as unity, then you see number of Einstein absorbed per unit time is actually the intensity. That is IA, intensity of the absorbed radiation. Okay. So number of moles reacting per unit time, that is minus dm dt. Okay. So phi is also defined as rate by intensity. Okay. So phi is if you consider a reaction, suppose you consider the reaction nu one A to product. And if IA is the intensity in Einstein of photon absorbed per unit time, then I equals minus 1 by nu 1 dCa dt. This is the rate. If you take the rate in terms of A, so what is your rate? The rate will be minus, since you consider with respect to, since you consider the rate with respect to the reactant, so minus sign will appear. So minus 1 by nu 1, where nu 1 is the stoichiometric coefficient. So minus 1 by nu 1 dCa dt divided by IA. So this is the phi. Okay. So this is the definition of quantum yield. Now there are several regions. If there is only primary process, okay, if there are no secondary processes, then you see the phi value will be 1. You will get from the restatement of the law of photochemical equivalence. That is the Stark-Einstein. Okay. If there are secondary processes, I may be different from 1. That is, for primary photochemical change, I value will be 1. And for secondary processes, I value may be different from 1. Okay. And the phi value is low if the excited molecule is deactivated by catalysis. I will be low if the excited molecule is deactivated by collision. If the excited molecule lose energy by fluorescence or phosphorescence, etc., then I value will be less than 1. If the secondary processes involve a state which produces a reaction molecule as one of the products, we have seen this in the inhibition state of the photochemical reaction between hydrogen and bromine. Okay. So where the inhibition states are present, in such cases phi value will be less than 1. Okay. But if an excited molecule gets deactivated, then phi may be less than 1. Yes, this is the inhibition state. This is the inhibition state. Where the reaction molecule is one of the products, this state is called inhibition state. Now, if an excited molecule gets reacted greater than psi value, maybe less than 1. Now, the reason of high quantum yield. The high quantum yield is attributed to 10 reactions caused by the generation of atoms or free radicals in the primary process. In these cases, I depends on the length of the chain propagating state. So the example, the phi value is 10 to the power 6 for the photochemical reaction between hydrogen and chlorine, and the phi value is in between 0 and 2 for the photochemical reaction between hydrogen and chlorine. So you see, the phi value gives the idea of secondary process. If there are only primary process, phi value is 1. If there are secondary processes along with primary process, then phi value may be different from 1. It may be less than 1 in some cases, or it may be greater than 1 in some reactions. Now, if the absorption of radiation lies in the banded region, the electron is excited to the upper level without causing the decomposition of the molecule. If the absorption of radiation lies in the banded region, then the electron is excited to the upper level without causing the decomposition of the molecule. That is, there is no chemical reaction. And the excited molecule may deactivate itself by any one of the following steps. These are the steps. That is, the fluorescence may occur or phosphorescence may occur, or there are secondary processes involved in steps which produces the reaction molecule. That is one of the products. Now, if the absorption lies in the continuous region, the molecule dissociates to produce active species which react with the reaction molecules or other molecules in the secondary region. So, there are two regions. The banded region, if the absorption of radiation lies in the banded region, then electron is excited to the upper level without causing the decomposition of the molecule. Okay. And if the radiation lies in the continuous region, the molecule dissociates to produce active species which react with the reactant molecules or other molecules in the secondary region. If you consider the reaction between hydrogen and bromine, you will understand all these matters. Okay. Now, the photosensitization reaction. In many photochemical reactions, the reacting substance is insensitive to incident radiation and does not absorb it. However, other foreign substances may be present. It may be mercury, it may be cadmium vapor, etc. These foreign substances may absorb the radiation and transfer the radiation to the reacting substance. You see, the reacting substance is insensitive to the incident radiation, and the foreign substances present in the mixture, they actually absorb the radiation of a particular wavelength and transfers the absorbed energy to the reacting substance by collision. Now, the reacting molecule becomes chemically active and will give the product. And this is the mechanism of the photosensitization reaction. And this reaction is called the photosensitization reaction, and the foreign substances present in the reacting mixture are termed as photosensitizers. Mercury acting as photosensitizer, it absorbs radiation of wavelength 253.7 nm. Hg plus H nu, Hg star. That is, mercury absorbs the radiation having wavelength 253.7 nanometers. Okay. And now mercury becomes excited. And when mercury combines with hydrogen, it exchanges the energy, that is the absorbed energy, or the excitation energy to hydrogen molecule. Now the hydrogen molecule becomes active. And the hydrogen molecule undergoes dissociation to give to hydrogen molecule. or HG star.